Alright guys, so today we're actually going to go ahead and hop on the cold air intake. We're going to try to clean out the throttle body a little bit. It is a little bit dirty. Who knows when the last time it was that it got cleaned, but we're going to go ahead and go through that, clean that out, and make sure that is pretty clean or as clean as we can get it. And then we're going to put the cold air intake right back on. Alrighty guys, so we went ahead and tightened this cable up a little bit. Went ahead and cleaned the throttle body, tightened this down, tightened that clamp down, and tightened that down. Tightened everything down over here that was loose from yesterday and painting and stuff. We're going to go ahead and try to give this thing a start and see if it helped with our throttle response. Alrighty guys, so it's the next day. First things first, we're going to hop on this quarter panel. We're going to start removing all the spot welds on the bottom that go along there, and then on top where that seal goes, and it drops right there where the little chrome piece goes, and it goes all the way that way, and it comes around the tail light. This quarter panel was actually wrapped, so there's going to be a lot of peeling and stuff off like this, but I wonder how clean this quarter panel is. But anyhow, usually right here, here are some spot welds if you guys can tell. But usually right here where the seam goes, where the rubber goes, is usually most of the time where the spot welds will keep moving. So I think that if we take this off with the wire wheel and focus on this over here and then peel this off and make our way up, I think we're going to be able to find out where exactly the spot welds go over here. I could be wrong. They might not be right here. They might be right here, but they're in this area right here. There might be them right here, actually. As you can tell, there's some spot welds that run along this thing right here. So we're gonna start focusing on drilling this quarter out and then measuring it up with the car and seeing exactly where we have to cut it on the car for it to match up with this. Alright guys, so as you see now, we took the seal off. All this stuff right here is super ooey gooey. I remember on the old Miata, my old black one that I had, I went ahead and resprayed that whole car to make it look super nice. So that was a couple of years ago. Paul V-Tune slicked that one in actually too. But I just remember taking the old one off. I remember it was super sticky, so I didn't even want to think about touching it with my hands. I used a screwdriver, and turns out it was. So we don't need that because we have ours, the whole piece that got cut off when we cut the quarter panel off. We need to pop this bad boy off. If anybody needs a part like this, let me know. I'm gonna have a piece, so anybody wants it, let me know. And then we're gonna have to clean this up super super good because I think there are spot welds that run through here, and I am correct. Here's one right here for sure. It's kind of hard to see, but they all run through here. And we're gonna clean that off with some lacquer thinner or something and hope for it to be nice so we can see all the spot welds. Look at that, cleans it right off without a freaking issue. Yeah, this lacquer thinner stuff is when you is for paint and stuff when you guys are messing around with painting cars. It's a really strong cleaning chemical. It could be used for other things too, but I think the main thing it's used for is for paint on a vehicle, and I could be wrong, but that's okay. But yeah, this stuff is really bad, and it burns worse than gasoline. I had this stuff one time get in my eye, and I thought honestly I was gonna go blind, but just kept washing it out, and over a couple hours, I think, or a couple long minutes, it went away. But now, guys, that is super cleaned up. Now you can see the spot welds running through it. So we're gonna go ahead and start tapping those bad boys out and make our way over here and start hitting these spot welds. Kind of, as you guys can see, there's three layers of metal, so we need the very outside one. So we're gonna start taking all these spot welds out and seeing what we can do. All right, guys. So we ripped off a couple inches of the clear, not the clear, but the wrap that he had on the quarter panel, and it's not looking too bad. It's gonna need a, except right here on the bottom, you can tell it's kind of spider webbed. Looking at this quarter, I'm thinking we're just gonna take off spot welds from this line up, so when we put it onto our car, we can actually, you know, put it back how it should be. And then we could, at the end, see it drops all the way down, and I can fill it all the way to the bottom. We could honestly bondo this right here and make it look probably like, you know, there isn't a line there. So I think that might be the route we're going to take just to make it, you know, a little bit better. And yeah, a lot of people won't even notice, but we're going to see if anybody does. All right, guys, so we kind of gave this little seam right here a clean, little wipe down so we can see exactly where the spot weld. You guys can see it better now. Super hard to see because there's a bunch of dirt and stuff here, but a whole lot more visible now. You can see them go from here to here to here and all the way down. So yeah, I think the best bet, and there's some over here, I think the best bet is we're gonna have to go through here and then bondo this at the end, and then I think it'll turn out pretty freaking cool. All right guys, so as you can tell, we got some of these spot welds drilled in all the way down to the bottom and up to that thing. We're gonna go ahead and use a spot weld remover and remove those spots that we already drilled. I am using a little bit of oil so we can put our spot weld remover bit inside of here, and then it'll use some oil and kind of cut through it. I think it helps with cutting the metal, but I've done it like this for a while and I'm probably gonna keep doing it, so it's something I've always done. Alright guys, so we kind of just ran through and try to hit the spot weld as good as we can. We're going to try to start prying on these. And I'm going to start by trying to separate the quarter panel from the skin from the actual quarter panel itself. It's going to be a lot of hammering and stuff probably involved just to get behind these little, to get behind the skin. I think this one's almost out. Alright guys, so now we just kind of go to where these spot welds are. I kind of messed this first one up because I wasn't really paying attention. Alright, so that one's free. This one's starting to become free. But there's going to be a lot of hammering and kind of prying like this right here just to get to these spot welds. So probably gonna have to put you guys in a time lapse or get back with you guys whenever we're done picking at this. Alright guys, so as you guys can tell, it's kind of splitting right here. The skin is from the actual quarter panel itself, and we're using a chisel and a hammer, and we're just going through and just punching it all out. So we're gonna go ahead and keep moving with it, and then we're gonna go all the way down from here and then to there, knock that out, and then we're gonna go through the tire where the tire goes right here in the fender well, and then we're gonna do the top last just so it could be our protection or it could hold it up against each other. Alright guys, so as you can tell from this very top spot weld all the way down to across to these and a couple of these, they're all loose. Now we can kind of start tapping all this stuff back to its normal spot and just kind of hold, keeping it there. As you could tell basically from these spot welds, it should just pop right off like this is right here. It's kind of loose, but since like 90% of it is still connected, it's still gonna be on there pretty good. We got a couple, like three or two over here that we're gonna have to get, and then a couple on the bottom, as you can tell, over here. I don't know what all this stuff is. I know this is a wrap, but we're probably gonna take a wire brush to this and clean all this up right here so we can see if there's glue or whatever that they use. We can clean it off and we can find the spot welds and work from there. Alrighty guys, so we're gonna use this wire wheel right here to clean this section up and find our spot welds. As you can tell, it ends right here. It doesn't end actually right here, so we don't have to cut this section. So it's really good because it's honestly, like, I wish we could have bought this thing, but I couldn't find one for sale, like a new one, because it would have been super easy to change out and a lot faster than dealing with this. But this is all we had to work with, so we're taking the risk, we're risking it for the biscuit, and we're gonna try to make it work. Alright guys, so as you can tell, it's kind of cleaned up. We have a spot weld here, we have a spot weld here, and we have a spot weld here, and I think we have another one somewhere over here. I didn't go all the way yet. I wanted to show you guys this because I am about to start drilling these out, and then I guess I'll have to take all of this stuff off on the bottom, and we're gonna have to check it also. I kind of see the one right here in the reflection, as you can tell. Probably see the other one right here. So yeah, they are there, so we're gonna have to also wire weld that junk off. So we got everything loose over here. From here to here, there was a bunch of teeny tiny little spots also that had to get hit, not with the big old spot weld remover, but with the little drill bit, and we got those out. Everything from here on up is loose all the way to the top. I think we have like one or two more actually at the very top in the corner right there, but we're gonna go ahead and kind of slide our way over here and start knocking these out. There's a bunch that run through here, so we're gonna go ahead and tackle those And we're going to have to peel the wrap as we go, because you guys can see right there. You guys can see through the wrap where the spot welds even are. And then we have to go through there and go all the way over here and start taking this little glue stuff off. And then we're going to have to come over here and run through here and take off the spot welds under here. We got all of these right here from this corner all the way up to where this wrap starts. We got all these loose. We already separated it, and then we hammered it back, tapped it back so it could fall back in its original place. We're going to go ahead and start from here and move on up. We're kind of moving, guys. Alrighty, guys. So as you guys can tell, this whole lower section is complete. I can go back and tap this section back in. If I wanted to, I'm probably going to leave it open just because. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to focus on this section right here and see what we can get done today, since it is kind of getting dark on us. Alright, so moving right along, we got this section all drilled out. Now we can tap all this stuff right back in so it could be back into its little form whenever we put it onto the car. And then we can move on and jump over here and hit this. And then we can come up top and start working our way up and to the very top of it, and then we can have our skin off. And jump over here and hit this. And then we can come up top and start working our way up and to the very top of it, and then we can have our skin off.